much, Srikant ji, Manoj ji, and all my colleagues at the National Council of Science Museums fraternity. We are all part of the museum fraternity, and it's a great privilege and honor for me to come and inaugurate this exhibition on objects in the archive. And as Manoj Babu just said, I come from a museum which has art and culture, but also has some science, the Victoria Memorial Hall. In fact, everybody knows us for our paintings, but we also happen to have the fragments of the first telegraphic cable that was laid between Calcutta and Ahmedabad. We also have theodolites, which were used to measure heavenly bodies and so on and so forth. But I am privileged and I am really happy to stand here and witness this exhibition, Objects in the Archive, not as somebody who works in an arts and culture museum, but as a student of history. One of the saddest things in today's world, and this is true not only of India but also of the wider world, is that we tend to view the humanities and the sciences as two cultures, two separate cultures. In spite of all the talk about interdisciplinarity, this is a sort of, this is a divide which seems to grow year by year. We don't seriously read histories of science in our science curriculum. But this was not always so. And the two cultures is a modern phenomenon, and we don't any longer have in today's world the kind of intellectuals, the kind of personalities whom we describe as polymaths, who breach the walls of the humanities and the arts and sciences. So that era is gone, but I'm really happy as a student of history. Some of the most fascinating books that I have read as a student of history are on histories of science and technology, especially technology. One of the best books that I have ever read is two books actually by the same historian named Daniel Hedrick, called The Tools of Empire and Tentacles of Progress. Both are on technologies, how technology buttressed up European imperialism in the 18th and 19th centuries, including in India. So when we look at science and technology institutions, we don't really, the archival mindset is something that we again traditionally associate with historians and people who work in the archives. But I'm really overjoyed to see that the National Council of Science Museums and the CTRL, which is part of the National Council of Science Museums setup, and who have shown us the way to build science museums in India. The museum community in India, I'm new to the museum profession. I have not completed 5 years in the museum profession. So I have to look up to institutions that I really admire and try to learn from in all steps of my life. And NCSM is the leading one of them. And therefore it gives me particular pleasure to see that they have, they have taken pains to put together this exhibition on objects in the archive, technologies in the archive, because in the modern era we take technology for granted. When we hit a keyboard and we go onto the internet, or whenever you switch on the TV, anything, we use our smartphones, we take technology for granted, and we forget that what we are using, what we are taking for granted, has a long, long history through which many, many people have stood on each other's shoulders and on the shoulders of giants to make this possible. And it is our duty as citizens of this world, which is a product of historical evolution, to know these stories, know these stories of history and interconnectivity which lie behind these technological marvels that we use instinctively and we take for granted. And I'm really, really thankful that CTRL has put together this exhibition called The Objects in the Archive, which will show us, which will help us to contextualize what we use reflexively, instinctively, without really knowing the stories, the long stories behind this. So I'm really grateful to CTRL for giving me an opportunity to come to this and to see this exhibition, to learn from it, and to share the pleasures of it with all of you. Thank you very much. Please.